Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Joey Slam.
You. Yo, Joey. Where you at, my man? You, Joey.
Where's the light?
You, Joey, you in here, man? Yo. You good, man?
Hello?
Bro, you good?
Yeah, bro. Just here.
Just having some quality time with my mom.
You miss it, man?
I do. It's really lonely in here. I've been sleeping here for a few days now. I miss my pond, I miss my fish. So guys, let me go ahead and tell you exactly what happened with my eviction.
So guys, I have like some serious attachment with it still. This is the liner. Still all the stuff. I haven't gotten rid of it at all. Here all the pipes and everything. I was really deep in there. And then I have all the flooring. I have everything here. So a lot of you guys have been wondering what exactly happened. What happened with the eviction and everything. And this video is pretty much going to explain what's going on, what happened, and what will be happening in the future as well. But before we get in there, I want to talk about where my filtration is, where the remainder of my fish are. So to answer that question, we're heading to Blix's Exotic Catamaran Ranch.
Eviction review! Eviction review! Slayers, we're back at it with another slay venture. And right now we're actually at Blix's Exotic Animal Ranch. The beautiful barn, which is absolutely insane. Take a look around. It looks so good. We have the tanks here. And if, believe it or not, we look right back here. Something looks very familiar. Very familiar. These are my three trash cans. Now, guys, you guys saw in the video where I was forced to pop my pond, I had to get rid of every single thing. So, I contacted Blake, and I'm like, dude, you want to use my filtration on top of that? Because if not, all the beneficial bacteria and the biomedia will die and will be put to no use. So that's exactly what we did right here. So I'm going to show you guys an update on all my fish. If you look down below, we have Kitty. Kitty is down right there. We have Whiskers to the left, and we have our Tiger Shovelnose Red Tail Hybrid all the way up there, a little further up top. So everyone looks really, really good. They're happy and they're healthy. I'm looking for Blake Blair. He's doing some water changes right now, and he's working on his, he's working on his stingray tank right now as well. So what's going on, they ate already, right? They ate, so we don't have to feed them? They ate last night? Okay, so they're doing good. They're really acclimating well to their house. So I just wanted to show you guys kind of what's going on here. We pretty much brought my old system and we put it here at Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch, and they're doing good. Now, guys, I know I've had a lot of questions. I mean, a lot of questions in regards to what is happening, what is happening with the house, what's going on, what's the next move. So I'm gonna meet you at my place and we're gonna talk about that right now.
All right. So, I couldn't find it in myself to get rid of the pond, so it's here. But everything's gone. There's nothing here at all. All filtration's gone. As you guys saw, it's at Blake's. The fish are doing great. They're doing very good. I'm going to be visiting Blake very soon. But I also want to show you guys how my other fish are doing in regards to this very highly stressful situation. Come on. Come inside. Come. So the light that it goes on, this is pretty much what I got set up here so you guys can only see the fish. So we have the gopher here. We have Shrek. He loves to hide in his little pot. He's very happy in his pot. He does get he's a little sad too. He doesn't want to leave. I don't want to leave, but I gotta figure out something. So we have our two red lobsters right here who are doing well. This is something you don't get to see very often, guys, is where you see Avatar, my arrowhead puffer, completely under the sand. Check that out. That is so freaking neat. He's an ambush predator, he's amazing. And of course, you got Ninja. And he always follows me around. Come, buddy. Come. Let's go to the top. Check this out for a second. Watch my finger as it gets munched. Here, buddy. He won't even munch my finger, because he knows. Who knows his daddy? Just kidding. That's my finger. At least it wasn't like a parrot in that last video, guys. And then, of course, we have Yeti. And Yeti is doing pretty phenomenal in that tank. It's definitely significantly smaller in regards to the pond size, but there's so much filtration here, constant water changes. I have been taking care of my fish very well. As well as, we cannot forget one of the stars of the show, guys, right down here. Let's go ahead and show them off. Come, buddy. Come on. We have Godzilla, who's absolutely insane and such an awesome guy on our show. Come on. Oh my gosh. So, you guys want to know, I've been DM'd, emailed and everything, which is fine, but I've been taking some time to pretty much handle the situation, and now I'll be able to explain what exactly is going on with you guys. Alright guys, so while I'm going to be talking and explaining about the situation, we're also going to have some fun and feed our fish so you guys can see, because I know how much you guys really do enjoy me feeding my fish and my pets here. So we're just going to put that up there right now. I'm going to grab some Mazivore pellets. These are really, really, really good pellets for your fish, your lobsters. You guys already know. But I do want to say that I was basically almost evicted. I'm no longer going to be evicted. We have reached an agreement that I can stay in this location with all of my animals, these guys specifically, and the mantis shrimp Tyson and the other tank that I have right there for something very special. I'm allowed to stay here, and there's an agreement that I have 3 months to find a brand new place. So now I'm on the hunt for a house. It's never good to be evicted. It makes it very challenging to be able to possibly get a house and everything like that. So what ended up happening is, you guys know I harvest my water. When I harvest my water, I live on a corner place, and I block the entrance to everyone else's home. Everyone was okay, except one specific neighbor. That neighbor, which will remain unnamed for his purposes and everything like that, even though I personally wanted to just talk to him very, very sternly, we didn't really agree with what I had going on here, and unfortunately, we got a little verbal altercation, which forced his hand calling a fire marshal to come inside and do a random inspection. They called the fire marshal, he checked everything, he checked the electrical, he saw that apparently the pond was a fire hazard, where if I actually grab, you guys saw how much water came out of that pond. Watch, I'm gonna replay it right now.
That's crazy. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
And you guys can see, if there was any fire, I definitely would have been able to put it out in like 2.3 seconds. Pretty much, I didn't want to aggravate anybody. I had meetings with the supervisors here. I had meetings with the HOAs, everything like that with the association. And they just weren't too pleased in regards to me having a pond in my garage. So, out of respect for honestly just myself, because I need a place to live and my animals, I did what was asked and I removed the pond. I can stay here, like I said, between 2 to 3 months. And during that time frame, I would be looking for a place to live, preferably with waterfront, so then I can have my animals without an association issue, like the whole nine yards. So stay tuned. We'll be giving updates in regards to if I find a place. You guys will see the entire move. But no matter what happens, I gotta get out of here. I can't be having my pets here and be able to share these videos and make these videos for you guys if the association does not really agree with what I'm doing here. But pretty much, that's just like a huge summary. I can get into it more. If you guys want to, you can direct message me, everything like that. I know a lot of you guys were reaching out to me, offering ponds and offering like homes for my fish so that you guys can take care of them while I'm going through this entire situation. I want to say thank you so much. The Slayer family is so, so strong. We're almost at 500,000 now. Each and every one of you, like, I see every comment. I see it. I may not like it. I may not reply. I see every single thing that everyone says. And on the good, bad, positive, negative, it doesn't matter. But I do appreciate you guys. So let me shut up, and then I'm gonna go show you guys all my fish, all the fan favorites, and we're just gonna have some fun from here on out. Now for the fun part, where we go ahead and feed all my pets that you guys love so dearly. We have Yeti here, and Yeti is just moving like crazy, going back and forth, because since this is such a controlled environment, I can pretty much have this as hot as I can. And in the Amazon, believe it or not, when I was over there, which guys, I have not forgotten about all of those videos. I have tons. I've just been having to deal with my living arrangements as well as taking care of these animals. It's actually a lot when you don't have that extra help. So I promise you, the videos are coming out. I have so much to share with you guys. I just gotta worry about my fish as well as where I'm gonna be sleeping at night. But anyways, when I was over there, the water was really, really toasty. Like 82, 83 on a daily, like on a constant basis. If it was a flowing river or a lake, it did not matter. It was toasty. So let's see if I can get this guy to come up and eat. He smells it. If you check him out a little to there, you can see that he's looking around. You just gotta get a whiff of that once he finds it. I want a hand feel. Here you go, watch. Yeah, touch that whisker. Hey, buddy. That's so cool. I'm gonna go drop, let me see if I can get him to eat again on the surface. If not, I'm gonna drop a couple pieces of shrimp on the bottom and then move forward with all my other fish. Come on, buddy. I know you're hungry. Guys, take a moment. Appreciate this beautiful platinum red tail right here. Looks gold. Kind of. It's so cool. Oh, here he comes again. Here, buddy. Oh, you got a little spooked. I was a little too loud with him on that one. Come on. Come on, Yeti. Come on. Here you go. Come on. You know where the food is. I already fed you. A little more. There you go. Come on. Oh, what a good boy. So he's all good to go. Now, of course, you guys love to see Ninja eat. So what's going to be a little bit easier for you guys to see on that side, I think? All right, buddy. Come on. We'll open up both legs for you. We'll just do this. Come on. Right here. He's such a funny guy. And oh, I tried to hit him with it and he was too quick. Dude, he actually engulfed that entire shrimp. That entire shrimp. He had no chance. Oh, he's done. Look, he's ready to eat again. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Guys, look from above real quick to see this nice little slam right here. Come on, buddy. Oh, he's such a cool fish. It's similar to a snakehead, I can't lie. But these are water cow gobies. I usually call them my alien fish and ninja because he acts like a little ninja when he uses those pectoral fins and he just scoots through the bottom and stuff. These gobies are so cool. You wanna eat again? Dude, you hungry? Look at the size of this shrimp he's gonna eat, guys. Check it out, here you go. Oh my, all right, well, that's it. He's done, look at him. He's like, ooh, I'm so full. I can't eat anymore. And he's gonna sink to the bottom, look. He's literally gonna sink all the way to the bottom, watch. He's out here acting like he can still swim. Chill out, buddy. That's a lot of food. I feed him just roughly about that much every day. He's not even that fast anymore. Oh, wait. That's enough for him. I got just enough right here for Godzilla down below. And I also have enough for the gopher and, of course, our puffy fish right here, who is trying to hide in some plain sight. Of course, we have to go ahead and feed Shrek the gopher catfish. Here, buddy. Oh, I dropped it. Dang it. Hopefully, he doesn't pick it up in time. Yeah. Oh, he almost picked it up. Look at him come out. Here you go, buddy. Bad choice in today to wear a hoodie, as you guys can see. I am dripping all over the freaking stand. Here, buddy. You just came out. Why are you acting camera shy today? I'm just gonna drop that right in front of his den. Look, watch. He's gonna come up, pick that up, engulf that entire thing. He was a little camera shy today. He usually comes up to the surface. You guys have seen it several times where he comes up and he eats right out of my hand. And now I've made an entire mess. So I'm gonna save these two pieces right here for Godzilla, and then this piece should be for the puffer right here. So I gotta get tongs to feed them because he has a beak and that guy has a very strong bite force. But you guys saw the red lobsters right here eat. Guys, comment below if you should get into the breeding again, if you should make a whole bunch of red crayfish babies, a little red crayfish lobster babies. I would love to get back into that. So comment below in regards to wanting me to do that, and that possibly, as a huge thank you for everything, maybe do a giveaway where I send some out. A lot of you guys message me on a daily basis in regards to having me make some more babies and send them out, but right now I have no babies. So let me go ahead and put this here, and I'm gonna go look for a set of tongs. All right, guys, so we're all set. Got my tongs. We got our puffer fish right here. Sometimes he's just very picky where he wants to be hand fed. So sometimes you just gotta drop that there, get that set in the water, we'll come out. We'll love to see all this. See, he gets it come up right here. He got that whip. He sees it. Oh, he's gonna chase it. Look, oh. That was probably the most aggressive I have seen him attack his food. If you take a moment and look right now, guys, I know there's some little water marks because he kind of made a mess.
But look, he still wants to eat. I'm gonna give him a few moments, but we're about to go down. We're about to eat right now again. Here we go, I'm gonna grab this piece. We're gonna feed him again. Nice, big, healthy piece of shrimp. He likes to eat a whole shrimp usually. But here you go. Try to see if I get him in the glass. Oh, come on. Oh, look at that. Look at the popping, look at the popping. He's about to knock that whole piece down. And that should be enough for him. Look at that. Oh my goodness gracious. Now you guys gotta be on top of your water changes when it comes to owning these guys, because he pretty much ate a shrimp the size of him. And he's gonna, look, he's already bloated. He's all good there, he's just down. He might eat more, I've seen him eat more. But that's enough, because he lays some really, really, really big, big dookies. But this is gonna be sufficient enough for Godzilla down here, so let's see how he's doing. Hey Godzilla, how you doing, buddy? You doing good? Don't you do it. Don't. No. No. Good boy. All right, you get some food now that you were not mean. I want to get back to the point where I can hand feed him, but he's just getting so aggressive right now. It's just too much for me right now. I don't want to risk getting bit. Here you go. Look at that. Oh. Oh. That guy is wicked. Watch him closely as he just swallows that whole thing. You can let go of the fake plant there, kiddo. It's good. Oh my goodness. I love him. That's fake. That's not a good salad. There you go. He wants another piece. He's ready to go. Here, come on. Come, buddy. Let me try to get him over here so you guys can see. I'm gonna tap him on the head a little bit. Oop, you missed. Oop, you missed again. Here you go. Come over here. Got it. Now check that out as he swallows that entire piece of shrimp like it's no one's business. Oh, he wants to eat again. Look at him. He's like, Daddy, feed me. Watch this. Watch this as he grabs it from up top. Got it. Check that out, guys. What a beast. What an absolute beast, guys. So we decided to go ahead and drop a little shrimp right here for some shrimp. A little carnivore action. Look at him go. Zoom into his mouth as he does that real quick. That is ridiculous. That's so nuts as he rips apart that shrimp meat. Let's see if the lady wants to go ahead and eat. Come on, baby. Don't say remember. Gotta touch that antenna. Oof, look at that catch. That is a big meal. Looks like everyone's gonna be needing some serious water changes after this meal, guys. Slayers, thanks for listening. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's take a moment real quick. Look at our boy, Avatar, getting all cozy after a good meal. That's absolutely amazing, guys. Comment below what else you want to know about my life and what I got going on. It's such a shame that I have to be dealing with this and that I haven't been able to post so often because of that. But, well, whatever, guys. With that being said, we'll see you on the next adventure. Booyah.